Hi, my name is Dr. Brian Curtis. I am one of the paleontologists here at Fossil Crates. And today I wanted to walk through Tyrannosaurus Rex skull at a high level, just to talk about some of the features that we involve in our crates. So for starters, for those of you that have the ultimate Tyrannosaurus crate or are considering getting it, you get a hand claw, which you can't see here, but you get three different kinds of teeth. The first kind of tooth, and the largest in the crate, is the dentary tooth. It's the rooted tooth. And you can see here how thick the jaw is. So the tooth you get has the surface part and it goes way down here. The teeth of the Tyrannosaur went deep, and it had to go deep to survive the unbelievable amount of crushing bite force Tyrannosaurus provided when it chomped down. Another tooth you get is a shed maxilla, or upper tooth. This one here, in fact. You can see these teeth are gigantic, absolutely massive. Again, when you get them, they have double serrations. They were designed to rip punch through bone, rip out flesh, and when it ripped free, the serrations would help make sure the wound was extra jagged and messy and bloody. Just an all business monster. And up front, which we'll get a close up of in a moment, up here you have the premaxilla tooth. And they're a little more dainty than these other big monstrous daggers that it has. Tyrannosaurus Rex, actually, let's go ahead and move this. Editing. What you see there, right here, is those dainty maxillary teeth. So these premaxillary teeth, this is the bone, this is the line that separates, this is the premaxilla. And notice how tiny these teeth are in comparison. These are dainty, smaller teeth. But if you're staring at T-Rex, here's a crazy thing about this animal. If you are staring at T-Rex, he is staring right back at you. He has binocular vision. His eye is right here, and it's looking straight at you on either side. This skull was a little crushed when it was preserved. 66 million years looks pretty good, but it does have some side-to-side crushing, so it's not bilaterally symmetrical. But this side is really nice, and you can see he's looked straight into your eye. One of the most, if not the most, binocular vision-oriented dinosaurs. Unbelievable in its visual acuity. Right in here, in his big chunk, this is his nose. Some folks argued Tyrannosaurus Rex was a scavenger, and they made that argument based a lot on what's called nasal turbinates. If you were to x-ray this inside, you would see these crazy curlicue, tiny delicate bones. When he sniffed, air molecules went into the nose and went all through this crazy labyrinth before it got to the brain to tell it what it smelled, and it's working to figure out what was it that it was smelling. It's all up in here. Now, when you get a mouth like this, and you got a body like Tyrannosaurus Rex has, you know, a body like Sue, you're gonna eat what you want. However, if there was an easy meal, and you could just walk over and shoo some animals away, well, you might do that too, it's no problem. You are, after all, the king or queen of the meat-eating dinosaurs. So you can pretty much do what you want. Tyrannosaurus, as you can see, absolutely massive, huge bite, gargantuan teeth, a bunch of bananas that can rip right through you. Pure power. The jaw musculature popping out of here and going all the way down the side. This would have all been covered in muscle. This thing had massive bite power. That's why this animal had the most powerful bite of any land animal that ever lived. Now, because we are with the Tyrannosaurus Rex on display at the Museum of Paleontology at Brigham Young University, I'm gonna show you something cool they've done. We're gonna look over here at Deinosuchus. As we rotate this, oh, in the background's a cool Triceratops. Here is an animal that lived at the same time. If I zoom out the other way, you can see them both in the same room. But this creature here, this was the terror crocodile. Huge nose up here. Great, great nose. Its eyes right here and here. Looks just like a croc. Sit there, floating, nose just barely out of the water, breathing, eyes looking around, and then there it goes. But what's fascinating about this animal in comparison to T-Rex is despite its really long skull, The jaw muscular attachments just don't have the same level. The muscle comes out, it runs down this beautiful trough, which you can't see from that angle, I'll bring it around, and attaches here. But it just doesn't have the bite power of a T-Rex. And there you can see, zoom all the way out. Very, very powerful jaws indeed. The most powerful living land animal bite belongs to the Nile crocodile. The T-Rex is easily 3 times as powerful. So here you have a scenario where this crocodile is checking out that meat eater. But most likely, Deinosuchus would let Tyrannosaurus Rex walk on by. However, as we walk over here, you have this gigantic Triceratops, just enormous. He makes both of those skulls look tiny, and I didn't think that was possible. Well, I hope you've enjoyed some conversation about some really cool dinosaurs. Thank you kindly. Adios.